I want to speak to somebody who not just heard about operations in these areas. I want somebody who participated in the drug trade.
My friend, can you tell him what we discussed? I'd like to know some facts. We want to know exactly where to go.
¿Qué nos puedes mostrar acá de la zona?
Es el peñón donde yo ahí sí, porque ya era donde llegaba el submarino, que nosotros lo cargábamos.
Cuéntame sobre el submarino, ¿ok?
Eso ahí, eso llegaba ahí, eso se parqueaba. Solamente nosotros servíamos eras de mulita ahí, y ahí llegaba así a la una, a la madrugada, así, flotaba el submarino. Y nosotros todo el mundo se quedaba, era como nervioso ya. Todo el mundo agarraba saco, ya, para salir de eso rápido.
Chema, you know, I think he gets it because he's probably met somebody like me before and realizes when it's legit and when somebody's just on a sightseeing tour.
Comienzo no sabía ni qué era, si eso lo guardaban ahí.
Sí, llévanos.
Okay.
Okay. ¿Listo?
Vamos, sí. Pues.
No matter what you think of the guy, Pablo Escobar was an innovator. At one time, we know he was interested in submarines to expand his smuggling operations and to make it easier to get away from law enforcement. These submarines could carry up to 2,000 kilograms of cocaine into the waters off of Puerto Rico, where other smugglers would unload the drugs from the submarines, put them on fast boats, and drive them to Miami.
Ahí anclaban el submarino, detrás, ahí detrás de la roca. Después de la parte verde, la azul.
¿Qué tan grande eran los el submarino? ¿El tamaño del bote o más
o menos? No, no, más grande. Más grande. Más largo.
You know, he starts informing us, this is the amount of drugs, okay? This is at what time we did it. These are the types of boats we put them on. This is what the submarine looked like. And he's got so much, you know, information to his story that this is nothing that could have been cooked up on the fly.
Entregamos la carga, él salía. No, y ahí como a la semana venían las lanchas otra vez con la carga y otra vez almacenes.
Tú y tu familia.
Yes, we want people with current access. We want people like Juan Esteban. We want people like Popeye. But guess what? So far, Chema has shown me something of more significance that paints a better picture for me how operations were ran than Popeye has.
Dinero?
Ah, sí. Ah. Yo creo que en esta zona debemos encontrar un submarino de los que se hundieron en.
Like a sub sank.
Estoy diciéndole lo que yo vi con lo que es cierto. Porque lo mío no es nada, sino que es verdad lo que le estoy diciendo.
A narco submarine.
Yeah. So over there, there was with a submarine.
Chema seems to be a trustworthy guy. He's been honest with us from the start. He has a good lead on a potential dive site, a place that he believes is ideal for a sunken submarine that cartels could have used to smuggle money.
Maybe we can find this underwater.
Okay.
Yeah? All right, great dive.
Chema has probably had his eye on this. I bet that he's looked from time to time, but this region of the Caribbean is really active in storm season. In any sea storm, the currents and the winds are shifting the sand at the bottom of the ocean floor. So I think it's possible that this dive site has been down there for 20 years and only recently has been uncovered through a storm.
Did Chema bring me directly to the X?
It's possible.
But we're burning daylight, so we'll come back tomorrow morning.
There are historical reports that suggest narcos, when confronted by the Navy or the Coast Guard, dumped all the drugs and money overboard and fled. Maybe it isn't a submarine, but I can't overlook the possibility that this could be one of those things. I think it's worth the time to go check it out.
We want to be around here, this area, because it's the information like we have.
Yeah, Juan, if that structure has a lot of metal to it, we've got our magnetometer. We'll go out on the Zodiac. We'll go back and forth.
Yeah.
Hopefully we'll pick up an anomaly.
So, yeah, let's get the Zodiac in the water.
Well, step one is to figure out if anything's there to begin with, because why waste our time diving? This isn't for fun. And so we have the GPR team.
How much does a thing like that cost?
It's probably like 20 grand US minimum.
So don't drop it in the water.
That's right.
Yeah.
equipment works over water as well. Really, honestly, doing a survey in the same way they would do on the ground.
They do look pretty badass out there. I'll stay right here in the shade. Thank you very much.
Go back and forth around it. Where you think we might be over the top of it. We'll see if we see a big jump in the readings.
They start circling the site, searching for the strongest magnetic signatures on the bottom of the ocean.
Down at 475, 450, 430.
North to south?
South. South way.
Up a little higher. 600. 800.
You guys find it?
We did get quite a big jump in the readings just on the southwest side. We couldn't really close it off, but we were getting elevated readings there. I took a look over the side. The water's just not quite clear enough for me to see what it could be down there. I don't know if you guys want to send the diver down.
Yeah. So do you know how deep it is?
Between 11 and 20 meters. Yeah, so.
Juan, listo. Let's get the suit on and let's get you in the water.
It's exciting to get to use this technology on a place that hasn't been seen in God knows how long. We don't know what else is down there. We want a win badly. This is right on the equator, and it creates a lot of storm weather. It can completely change the ocean floor from season to season.
What did you find?
So much metal on the water. We found something like a box, but finally it was a battery. It's maybe from a Motorola, I don't know.
Yeah.
It's maybe something wrecked there before, but anything.
There's nothing, it's gone?
Yeah.
No money, no jewels, no drugs?
No, it's not like you want to.